Hi, and welcome to another episode of Mr. Puzzle. Today, we're gonna talk about another puzzle box, the Dice Box. And the Dice Box was designed by Benno Bartzen from the Netherlands and is manufactured by Mr. Puzzle Australia, which is, by the way, not related in any kind to this channel. It's a wooden puzzle box and it looks like a dice. This is all I know about this puzzle box, so let's just get it out of the box and let's have a closer look on the box itself. Okay, it comes also with the solution, obviously. I'm not sure. Yeah, here I can see it through the paper. There's written solution inside. Maybe it should be put on the outside, to be honest, not on the inside. But okay, it looks actually like a regular cube with a size of about 10 by 10 by 10. Centimeters, and let's see, number 6, number 1, number 3, number 4, number 2, number 5, so all in the standard place. And inside here there are some sliders that can be moved, and this makes me already think maybe I need to move them in the right sequence to open it up. And oh, and I see here some problem, obviously, with the manufacturing, which is pretty disappointing because I just took it out of the box and it's already damaged. You can see that these two, the number 2 and 4, obviously separated, so the glue does not remain in place. I will try to fix this myself, but after this video is completed, I hope this will not influence the inner mechanism here and everything works as expected. However, of course, I mean, I think you agree that no one wants to receive something like this. I just took it out of the box and it's already damaged, so it seems to be rather a poor quality, unfortunately. Well, however, I will try to solve it after the spoiler break, and then I give you my rating about the difficulty of this puzzle. Okay, so what can we do with these sliders? I'm very sure that these sliders here have something to do with the solution. Some can move a little bit more, some can move a little bit less, but I'm sure this is somehow, they need to somehow move in the correct position, and then we can open it up. But the lid. Okay, the number 6 seems to be the lid, so the number 1 down here is completely fixed, and it's actually pretty cool that they are numbered, because I don't need to put any any stickers or anything here on this puzzle myself. So usually if it's blocked like this, there must be some kind of a interlocking feature up here which holds it in place, and this can be probably moved here by these pieces. Oh, okay, there's a lot of movement here on this one, but in the wrong direction. I can actually only put it upwards. I can move this all the way around, but not really far. Only I feel there is some free play, as you can see here, but very few. I think that these sliders are somehow connected, that if I move the right one, let's say that's kind of a sequence. If I move one, I can move another one, and so on. This one, for example, I can move a lot. Oh yeah, this one has a lot of movement here. Maybe this is the starting point. No. Oh yeah, this one has also a lot of movement. Oh, this one has a lot of movement here. And put it all the way up. Maybe I can. No. Does it influence here? No. What I try now is I try to feel if there's a connection between these parts. So, for example, if I push this one over here and move this one around. I try to feel if there is any, let's say, any force transferred from here to here that I can feel, or any vibration that I can feel that these parts are connected, but there is actually no connection between these two. Didn't try the lid so far. But these seem to be completely fixed. All of them seem, oh no, this one has a little bit of free play. And it moves, it seems to be connected to this one, because I can see this one also moving if I move this one. Yeah, these are connected. So this one was so far moving the most. Oh, now I can also, oh, okay. Have you seen this? So if this one is in the middle, I can't move this one. Okay, and I can see they are connected. You see this? Oh yeah, I can put this all the way to the top. This one not. This actually looks like it's connecting or closing the lid here. Okay, so wow, this one I can move very much to the upper side. This one is the same as before. Oh, okay, okay, I think I got it. So I move this one to the left, this one up, and now I can move this one also to the left, because it's probably here interfering with this piece, like two sliders. This one is blocked in the beginning. If I move this one up, then this one is free to move. I think this is how this works. Okay, and now I need to find the next piece. Oh yes, now I can move this one. This one is still blocked. Oh, I can, yeah, I think we are on the right way here. I can move this one over here, this one up. So they are all interlocked in all directions. Pretty cool design. I like the idea here. It's like a chain. I can move one by one. So far, no change here to the lid. This one over here. This one down. Left. Now I can very likely move this one to the left. No. Okay. So, no, it's blocked. Maybe up. No. Okay. Up. Ah, okay, and now I'm, oh, you probably didn't notice, but after I moved the last one here, the number one here came down by itself while I was rotating the cube. Here I started, I haven't moved these two before, but now I can move this one all the way over here. And this one is blocked. It's blocked by this one, which I cannot move back right now. So I'm absolutely sure this one is locking the lid. So I need to move it left, right, or down, probably. This one, I was not able to move this one before. So I moved this one now over here, and I thought I could move this one down, but not working. Also, I'm not sure, this puzzle box is meant to be 29 steps, and I'm not sure if this were already 29 steps, so let me just double check. 1, 2, 14. So we have 14 steps. It's nearly the half. Oh, I think I know how to do it. If I move this one, I can see a very small movement here on this one. Means this one is preventing this one to move right now. This was movable in the beginning, but now it's completely blocked. Means, oh yes, that's a great idea, I think. I will go back to the beginning. If I go back to the beginning, this one should be able to get back in the middle, then this should be movable. And this one is in another position as in the beginning, so maybe I'm able to move it and downwards. The lid is still locked. So this one is still in this position now. Yeah, different as before. So I go back. this is so cool here. So many steps with all these sliders inside. And now, let's see if I was right. This one, yeah, now the difference is, the only difference to the beginning is, this one I can now not go get back anymore, but this one is now in a different position, which enables me to move this one here, which was not possible before. And now I can move this one back, and now I'm very sure. Ah, okay, I need to move it down, not left or right. And now the moment comes. Yes! Yes! This is so satisfying to be right on this. So let's see. Here we go. And yeah, okay, you see, it was locked by these two pieces here, it seems. Mainly by this one. And this one is held or blocked, prevented to go downwards by this one. And the number one down here. You need to move all the holes all the way around until you reach number one, then you change the position of number one, and then you put them back in position to be able to move the last two pieces here, which you didn't touch in the beginning. Pretty brilliant idea. So great design here by Benno Bartzen. However, I'm not very happy with the manufacturing quality on this puzzle, so I'm not sure if I can recommend this one. I think this is maybe a flaw which only hits me. If you buy this puzzle, you will be probably more happy with the quality than I am. The difficulty, I would give it a, even it took me some time, I would give it a 3, because after you understand the mechanism behind, the idea behind, it's pretty much straightforward. However, I will give this also to some other people to see them, or to enjoy seeing them struggling, same as you do here on my channel with me. By the way, you can also get a building plan here of this puzzle on the website of Benno Bartzen. I will link you his YouTube channel and the building plan in the video description. So I will get this just locked again. And here we go. Back again in locked condition. This one is blocked again. This one is blocked again. Puzzle is locked. So I will just glue this thing up now. Hope it will look like new afterwards. And I hope you enjoyed this episode as much as I enjoyed solving this puzzle box. If you would like to learn more about puzzling, you can also check out my Facebook and Instagram channel. And until next time, keep on puzzling.